ceremony at the White House earlier this morning. Mr. Daniel Morris is not believed to have been the president's first choice. The new vice president was sworn in at a Rose Garden ceremony. Mr. Daniel Morris is not believed to have been the president's first choice. The new vice president was sworn in at a Rose Garden ceremony at the White House earlier this morning. Mr. Daniel Morris is not believed to have been the president's first choice.
Okay.
The new vice president was sworn in at a Rose Garden ceremony at the White House earlier this morning. Mr. Daniel.
Thank you.
We're sending you down to...
President was sworn in at a Rose Garden ceremony at the White House earlier this morning.
So you didn't get it?
It was quite a blow. That witness possessed information about the Ortmeier files or their location.
Ortmeier files?
Dr. Ortmeier ran an underground cloning lab in Romania. We raided it as soon as we learned about it, but someone beat us to it. They'd ransacked the place, grabbed all the files, and killed everyone that worked there, even Ortmeier. But that was the least of our concerns.
What do you mean?
We did find some papers later. Enough to prove that Dr. Ortmeier created Mr. 47. No one else has successfully created a Class 1 human clone. Dr. Ortmeier literally wrote the book.
And somebody stole it.
Not just somebody. Where's the nurse?
Whoa.
Sorry. I don't like being dependent. Something as simple as lighting a damn cigar, it's just... I apologize. Could you...
Of course. So, who stole the research?
We found a surveillance tape. It clearly showed Mr. 47 killing the guards and snapping poor Dr. Ortmeier's neck.
So 47 wanted to build his own clones?
More likely, he wanted to sell the research to the highest bidder. It lit a fire under everyone's asses. We threw everything we had at him. It's all there.
Hello, 47. The American Secretary of the Interior is being targeted for assassination at today's Mardi Gras parade. We're not sure who's behind the hit, but our client wants you to prevent it by taking out the would-be assassins. There are three. The leader is Mark Pariah Jr. His associates are Raymond Kolinsky and Angelina Mason. Kolinsky's a former world-class biathlete, so he's probably the trigger man. Mason is probably just recon and support. They're romantically involved and mentally unstable, so expect a violent reaction if either of them learns the other is dead. Their whereabouts are a mystery, but we've identified the payment on its way to them. The money should lead you straight to them. There'll obviously be a lot of civilians in the mix on this one, and a high-profile hit like this is bound to have backup units on site, so you'll have to be even more discreet than usual.
There's the handoff.
Follow that briefcase, 47. It's the only lead we've got.